Hello, everyone. Thank you so much for joining our webinar today. If you are brand new to SDocs, welcome. We're very excited to have you. And if you're already familiar with us, welcome back. My name is Zach Bruick. I'm the marketing manager here at SDocs. And today we're going to be talking about the basic first steps to take after downloading SDocs to get the most out of the product. With me here is Paul Burt, our senior solutions engineer, who is going to be presenting today. Paul, I will pass it over to you.
All right. Thank you, Zach. Hi there, everyone. Now, as Zach mentioned, for today's webinar, we will be talking about what the first steps are after you've initially installed SDocs. Now, a few questions that you might be asking yourself are, you know, we want to use the SDocs free version for the sake of a proof of concept, but we're not sure where to begin. Maybe you're wondering if you how you can determine if the free version is right for you. You might also be wondering how SDocs can step in and replace an existing solution that you are using inside of Salesforce. Or how do you make the first template once you get this installed? All of those are common questions that we encounter, and for today's session, we will look to answer all of those and then some. Now, before we get too far into it, let's just start off with a very high level overview of what is SDocs. Now, in a nutshell, SDocs is a 100% native Salesforce solution that allows you to take Salesforce data, merge it into templates, and produce a variety of documents. Now, those documents might be letters, quotes, invoices, emails, and so on. Really, the sky's the limit. If there is a document that requires Salesforce data, SDocs is a great candidate. Now, I did mention that SDocs is 100% native to Salesforce, and this is a major distinction that differentiates us from all other solutions available within the document generation and e-signature space. Now, with other solutions, your Salesforce data is ultimately merged into a template, but in order to make that merge happen, the other solutions will take your data from Salesforce and send it outside of Salesforce to an external processing center. Now, with SDocs, that is not at all the case. When you are using documents or e-signature functionality, the data literally never leaves your own Salesforce instance. We don't have visibility to it, and it never leaves the confines of your own org. Now, of course, that has some major distinctions, things like security, speed, ease of use, and compatibility with Salesforce technologies are all benefits that you will encounter when using a 100% native application like SDocs. Now, for today's webinar, we are going to cover a few different topics. We are going to begin with what it looks like to build your first SDocs template using the SDocs template builder. The second thing we will take a look at is what it looks like to quickly upload your own PDF as a template. Third of all, we will take a look at what it looks like to actually generate and email our first document. And finally, we will explore some additional functionality, including things like community compatibility, electronic signature, automation, and so on. Throughout this demonstration, I encourage you to pop your questions into the chat, and we will address those following the live demonstration. But at this point, let's go ahead and hop into Salesforce and we can see SDocs in action. Now, like I mentioned, the first thing that we will cover is what it looks like to create your first template using the SDocs editor. Now, the first thing that we will do is, of course, navigate to the SDocs templates object in Salesforce. Once we are here, we will click this new button to create our first template. In this example, we will give it just a placeholder name. We will configure this template to work with the account object. And keep in mind here that SDocs is compatible with any object that you might be using in your org. All standard objects, custom objects, and even objects from other third-party applications are supported. The next thing that we will do is choose the type of file that we are looking to generate. In this example, we will stick to PDF, but keep in mind that we do support a variety of others, including Word documents, emails, Excel sheets, PowerPoints, and more. But now that we have these key fields set, we can go ahead and click Save. this is going to create the actual template in Salesforce. And the next step is to build the template itself. Now to do that, we will click this template editor button that exists beneath this dropdown. Once we click this button, it leads us to the SDocs template editor. And the first thing that you might notice is that this is a 100% native template builder that just lives and breathes inside of Salesforce. This template builder is designed for everyone from a business user all the way to a developer to be able to build some sophisticated templates. Now, the first thing that I would usually do when building a template is add any information that does not need to change from one document to the next. This could be paragraphs, pages worth of text, but in this example, let's just keep it simple and type in this phrase. Now, once we have some text added to the document, the next thing that we can do is apply some formatting. And you might notice that we have this toolbar here that is, again, a point and click editor that allows you to add all of your different formatting elements. The lower segment is used for things like font formatting. You can manipulate your font type and size, coloration, alignment, and so on. You can use the upper segment of the toolbar for adding other formatting elements, things like images, tables, and page breaks. So the formatting here is quite intuitive. What I'm really going to focus on is the ability to get some dynamic information into this document. In this example, since we are working with the account object, let's imagine that we want to merge the account name field after the word text. All we have to do here is click Insert Field, and it automatically displays a list of all of the fields on our base object, or in this case, the account. We would simply scroll through, choose our desired field, click Insert, and that's literally all that it takes. Once we generate this document with some live data, the account name field will be automatically swapped into this location. Now you might wonder, I have, you know, data points that don't reside on the account directly, but rather exist on a related object. How do I access those? All we have to do again is click Insert Field and find any of these entries with the greater than symbol next to it. Clicking this gives us the flexibility of opening those related objects in all of their fields. And keep in mind that you can keep drilling multiple levels deep into the data structure here to, again, give you the flexibility of pulling fields from anywhere in Salesforce. Now, that's something to note that with SDocs as a native application, we are capable of merging in information from anywhere in your entire Salesforce system. As long as the data exists inside of Salesforce, SDocs can consume it into a document. And that is certainly not the case with other non-native document generation tools. So again, all we have to do here is click Insert, and our field will be added into the document itself. Now, the next thing that we will talk about is what it looks like to include a related list. And just by way of quick explanation, a related list is a dynamic table that is going to be used to display those one-to-many relationships that you might be looking to summarize. An example that I like to think of is a dynamic table that shows all of the line items related to an opportunity. You could imagine that a customer might be purchasing one product, they might be purchasing 10 products, or even more than 100. Therefore, we would need a dynamic table. And that's exactly where the SDocs related list function comes into play. Now, all we have to do here is click Insert Related List, and we would start by choosing which related records need to populate our list. In this example, let's say that we are interested in the contacts linked to the account. Once we have that selected, we can next choose the fields that need to be displayed from each one of those contacts. And keep in mind that you can select one or as many fields as you need here. Now, once our fields are chosen, we could use these tabs up above to add some more advanced attributes, things like filtering and sorting behavior, changing the formatting of the table, and applying some manipulations to data. But for today, let's keep things simple. At this stage, let's just click Insert, and we should now see that we have our table header added into the document. When we generate this with live data, this table will be populated with one row per contact linked to our account, these three fields displayed from each. And keep in mind that we still do have those point and click edit capabilities at our disposal. We have not sacrificed any of that. So in a nutshell, this is what it looks like to create a template. And if we take a look at a template that I already have built, this is what your template might look like after you've spent some time adding various tables, fields, related lists, and so on. Now we will see this template in action here in a few moments, but at this stage, let's go ahead and toggle to our second topic, which is the PDF upload feature. Now this is a convenient feature if you already have a PDF on hand and you want to upload it as your template rather than having to manipulate it via the point and click builder. So this is really in essence used to speed up your template development process. Now, if I open this template up here, you'll see that it's really a dramatically different editor. If this was a brand new template, it would prompt us to choose the file that needs to be uploaded. But I've, of course, already performed that in this example. Now, we see here that this PDF that we upload can really have any content in it that you deem fit. Things like images, custom headers and footers, specific coloration and fonts. It really doesn't make a difference what is present when this document is uploaded. But ultimately, once we get this uploaded, the next step is to take some Salesforce data and map it where it needs to ultimately merge into our PDF file. To do that is a very straightforward process. Using this button here on the left side of the page, we can click Select Merge Field. And this opens a function very similar to what we've already seen. We can go ahead and choose our field. And once it's selected, simply drag it and drop it where this data needs to appear. And it's really just a matter of repeating this process once for each desired data point. Keep in mind that you can apply styling to these various fields if you want, for instance, green text applied to a data value. You can also add conditionality to whether a field is merged or not. So an example I like to think of is maybe we only want to render a discount field if the discount is greater than 0%. So again, it's just a matter of iterating through and dropping one of these tags per data point that needs to be merged. And that's really all that you have to do in order to spin up this type of template. So you might find that during your testing process, this is capable of really jumpstarting it and making it a faster process than the point and click editor. Now that takes us through PDF upload. So the next thing that we are going to do is take a look at SDocs in action. Now I mentioned that template that we would see live in use. Let's go ahead and generate it. In this example, we are going to generate that PDF template, but we are also going to select an email template so that we can deliver the PDF electronically. To kick things off here, we will click the SDocs button that is placed here on our page. Once we click this button, it leads our user to the template library. And this is where we can see any of the templates that are configured within our org. We would simply select the templates that need to be generated. And keep in mind that we support all those different file types that I mentioned earlier, in this case, PDF and email. Once they are selected, we will click Next Step. And at this point, it's merging the data from the accounts and any relevant related records into the template and producing the actual output file. Now this file has finished generating at this point. So if we open it up, we can see again that this is the version of the same template that we saw earlier, but with the data now included. Log back in there, but we can see here that this document is filled out with a variety of different data points, things like the account's shipping address, account number, revenue, and more, plus a couple examples of those dynamic related list tables that we discussed earlier. In this context, showing the contacts related to the account, as well as the opportunities related to the same account. So this is what our generated file looks like, but let's go ahead and resume the workflow. Coming back to this screen, the next thing that we will do to send this out via email, of course, is click this button. Now this leads us to the And I apologize here. It looks like I was getting logged out for whatever reason, but let me just quickly go ahead and regenerate that file. All right, so when we click this email button, it's going to lead the user to the SDocs email interface. And this is the first stage where we see the email template come into play. Now, the email template is used, first of all, to produce the body of the email itself. And ultimately, since this is an SDocs template, you can make this email look and feel however you would like from a content and branding perspective. In this example, it's relatively basic, but we are including a couple of images, a couple of field merges, and an automatic body to this email. Now, keep in mind that the user does have the flexibility to customize this on the fly if desired, but that's completely optional. Now, the other thing that this email template is responsible for is automatically filling out fields on the email itself. In this example, we have dynamically formed both our BCC and the subject line, but keep in mind that any of these can be pre-populated. Any of them can also be locked down if the user should not be able to edit it. But in this case, we will just go ahead and choose the to address, click send, and really that's that. Our recipient now has their customized document and email arriving at their inbox. But the thing I would like to point out here is that every action we just took is automatically recorded inside of Salesforce. First of all, the email is going to display as an activity, and this shows us who we delivered the email to, any attachments that we included. It can even tell us whether the recipient has opened the email or not. The documents themselves will link to one of a few different locations. In this example, we have it configured to save to this SDocs related list. Now, this is a completely customizable list. You can add various columns to show you things like when a document was created, the user that might have created it, the name of the document itself, and a variety of others. SDocs is also capable of linking to other repositories, things like Salesforce files and attachments, as well as third-party storage like SharePoint, Drive, Box, and so on. But really, that concludes the workflow that I wanted to show for our third topic. So moving on to our final topic, the other thing that I'll do here is just mention some of the capabilities that we don't have time to take a look at today. Now with SDocs, in this example, we saw that this was a user-driven document creation, meaning that a user had to click a button. But one very common use case that we come across is that a customer needs documents to produce without the user's manual involvement. So something that I like to think of is a renewal reminder that needs to be sent out automatically 30 days before someone's subscription expires. Another good example is an automatic pipeline report that is delivered to all of the internal sales team every Monday morning at 9 a.m. And the examples go on and on. There are many different cases for automating your documents. But with SDocs, that is something that is very straightforward to do. Since we are a native application, we are capable of integrating with Salesforce Flows, Process Builder, even custom triggers to make this a completely headless experience. SDocs also supports electronic signature functionality via our tool called SSign. And just like SDocs, SSign is 100% native to Salesforce. We can also do various other things like connect with your Experience Cloud, as well as GovCloud and any other Salesforce environment that you might be using. We can be embedded in a variety of different workflows, screen flows, and so on and so forth. So really the thing to keep in mind here is that since we are native, we are compatible with virtually any Salesforce technology that you might be using today, including mobile and others. But that really concludes the demonstration portion for today. So coming back to our slideshow here, the next thing that I would like to point out to you is that we have a variety of resources on our website that are intended to make your trial or investigation of SDocs successful. The first thing that I will point out is our template library. This is a repository of pre-built templates that you can import into your system in literally a matter of seconds. We have various things like letters, quotes, invoices, and so on. So I highly encourage you to see if there are any documents similar to the document that you are looking to build in your own organization. Now, on our website, we also have a variety of different videos that explain features, give how-to explanations, and so on. So if you're a fan of the video style content, again, head to sdocs.com. And finally is our knowledge base. And this is really the exhaustive resource that covers all things sdocs and sign. It is a searchable repository, so you can just go to the knowledge base, type in the name of a feature that you're looking to learn more about, and you will have at least one article returned. These articles contain screenshots, videos, written explanations, and more. So I highly encourage you to go check out some of the different things that are possible with sdocs using our knowledge base. And again, you can find these different resources at sdocs.com. You can also feel free to contact our team at sales@sdocs.com if you would like to have a customized conversation or demonstration that pertains to your specific needs. But at this point, I would like to open it up to questions. So Zach, do we have any questions?
Yeah, thank you, Paul, for that very informative walkthrough. And thank you to our audience for asking some great questions along the way. So there are a few have been asked that I've typed answers to, but I thought you could elaborate a bit more. So one is, can you use SQL queries with sdocs?
Yeah, that's a great question. And yes, as a native application, sdocs is completely compatible with SQL queries. You can embed a query directly into a template to fetch data from anywhere in the system. And as you probably understand, that's a very powerful feature because we can even do things like subqueries, aggregates, grouping behavior, really anything that Salesforce supports on the SQL side of things can be leveraged within the context of a template. So absolutely, yes.
Great, thanks, Paul. We had another question about template selection, and it has to do with filtering the templates that are displayed to the user after clicking the sdocs button.
Okay, yeah, that is absolutely something that we can do. If you may have noticed, but after we click the sdocs button, there was a dropdown in the upper right that is called Document Category. Now, this allows you to organize your templates by various attributes, whether it's region, language, line of business, type of document. It's completely customizable. However makes sense in your context to organize the documents can be achieved. And that dropdown can be automatically selected based on a field value back on the record itself. So the example that I like to think of is maybe we are delivering a quote and we want to look at the language that our customer works in and automatically select the category that pertains to that language. So again, it could be a variety of parameters like language, region, and so on. But the short answer to that question is yes, we can default into a category. And by the way, you can lock it so that the user cannot override the category if you don't want to give them that level of flexibility.
Great. Another question here says, our clients do not want to store documents in Salesforce. Can we store documents in SharePoint?
Yeah, great question. We do have a SharePoint integration built directly into sdocs. Setting it up is very straightforward. All you have to do is plug in your SharePoint credentials, click authorize, and the sdocs package automatically does the rest of the config. Now that is pre-built into our solution for some other repositories as well, like Drive, Box, and a couple others.
Great, thanks, Paul. Another question here. Can we make some templates only available to certain public group users?
Yeah, that's a great question. So again, since we are a native application, we are completely compatible with the Salesforce sharing model. So you can restrict templates by user profile, permissions, you know, any of those mechanisms within Salesforce that you would use to control what a user can access can be applied to the templates themselves, including public groups.
Thanks, Paul. Another question here. Someone asked, if I need to generate and send out a couple hundred custom docs at once, can sdocs support that?
Yes, so that is something that we do support. Now, we didn't see it today, but we have a feature called Mass Merge. And essentially, Mass Merge allows you to generate a document or multiple documents for more than one record at a time. The way that it works is that the user navigates to any Salesforce list view, which, by the way, can have any filters on it that you deem fit. They select the records, click a couple buttons, and documents are produced in mass. So it's literally a matter of seconds to produce potentially hundreds of different documents.
All right.
And,
thanks,
and
Paul.
One thing I'll caveat that with or add to that is that that is a feature that can be used to achieve mass emailing. Now, that might not be obvious. Typically, people are thinking of PDF documents. But since, again, an email is just another document, that mass merge feature can be used to mass email prospects, customers, or whoever it might be.
Perfect. Now, some more questions here. Are we compatible with Net Documents or Ignite?
You know, I am not sure about that. I'm not sure what the answer to that is, but you can feel free to send that question to us at sales@sdocs.com, and we will find an answer by the time you reach out. You've stumped me. Good work.
Great. Thanks, Paul. So another question here. Does SDocs support translating documents into different languages?
Yes, absolutely. So SDocs can translate documents in a variety of different ways. The first way that jumps to mind is that we are completely compatible with Salesforce's translation workbench feature. The other thing that jumps to mind is that our templates do also support conditional logic. And conditional logic is useful for determining which section of a document should be included or excluded. So a perfect example there is translation. If the customer language equals French, then use this French verbiage. If it equals Spanish instead, then use the Spanish alternative, and so on. You can also use that feature for achieving some dynamic terms and conditions or product listings, or again, whatever it might be. It's a very powerful feature, but especially for translation.
Great. Another question here is, can I generate a document without a user having to click a button and select a template?
Yes, absolutely. So what we saw today was really the most manual approach to generating a document because we had to click the button, choose our templates, and continue through each step of the workflow manually. But you can automate SDocs in a variety of ways. Now, the most basic form of automation is just eliminating that template selection step so that when the user clicks a button, a template is automatically selected. Keep in mind that that can be a simple selection, meaning that it always chooses the same template, or it can even be a dynamic selection, meaning that based on a field value on our record, we choose one of a few different templates. Now, again, that's the most basic form of automation, but you can even scale it all the way up to where the user does not really have to interact with SDocs at all. If you think back to our flow integration, you can use Salesforce Flows to produce and email documents without a user having to do a single thing. And there are even automation points in between those two examples that I just gave.
Great. Can I send documents where users have to input data into form fields and then write that data back to Salesforce?
Great question. So that is something that we can achieve, but that does require usage of S-Sign, our electronic signature product. Now, of course, S-Sign is capable of collecting signatures, but S-Sign is also capable of collecting other types of inputs, things like drop-down pick list, text fields, numbers, and so on. Now, the real perk to this function is that any of those S-Sign inputs can be mapped back to a designated field in Salesforce, so that when someone submits a document, what they have keyed in is automatically transformed or synchronized to the record itself. So you don't have to necessarily collect a signature, but that is the function that would allow us to achieve that use case.
All right. Well, thank you so much, everybody. I know there are still questions that haven't been answered, so I will pass it back to Paul, and he will explain how you can contact us with those additional questions.
Yeah, so like I've mentioned, if you do have additional questions or if you would like to dive into your use case further with one of our team members, certainly please reach out to us. It's sales@sdocs.com, and we are happy to follow up on any of the different topics that you might be interested in.
All right, thanks, Paul, and thank you to everybody who joined today. We hope you have a great day.